The Queen's Favorite Restaurant Reviewed. Classics Revisited, Bellamy's, the Queen's favorite restaurant where French food has a posh English accent. In the recent storm in a coffee cup swirling around the £15 cup of Joe served at Le Café Alain Ducasse, the news that Le Chocolat Alain Ducasse next door is selling 3 kilograms chocolate bars for £160 seems to have passed unnoticed. Do you love anyone enough to give them your last chunk? The Monsieur Ducasse bars are definitely not me. Instead, I'm with Gavin Rankin, the proprietor of Bellamy's on Bruton Place, who is usually to be heard intoning "Never underestimate the power of cheap chocolate" as he cheerfully plonks down a glass of Galaxy Minstrels next to the Café au Lait. As the old Galaxy tagline used to ask, "Why have cotton when you can have silk?" I suspect that it is unpretentious touches like that which explain why Bellamy's is the only London restaurant that the Queen has ever dined at. I used to think the reason was because she was born around the corner at 17 Bruton Street and, like the natal homing that compels a salmon to return to the river of its birth, her major felt an instinctive affinity with this corner of Mayfair. But then I found out that the Queen's first visit to Bellamy's, in 2006, was to celebrate the 80th birthday of Lady Penn, one of the Queen Mother's ladies-in-waiting. And being just as susceptible to a friend's recommendation as the rest of us, the Queen came back 10 years later, this time with Princess Anne and Princess Alexandra in tow. Did they split the bill three ways on their Coutts cards? Rankin is far too much of a gentleman to say. Bellamy's probably isn't due another royal visit until 2026, but if you're in the mood to celebrate the Queen's birthday on the 21st of April, you couldn't find anywhere with a more authentic seal of regal approval. Professional and personal expenses, alas, not extending to the 25 grams of Isatra caviar that the Queen kicked her meal off with, I dived straight into her next course, a starter of smoked eel mousse. Glossily textured and gently flavored, it is served with 5 lightly bronzed slices of Melba toast, like a high-class canapé. The rather plain-looking Dovercil with oil and lemon that a pinstriped gent was tucking into on the next table put me off ordering the Queen's favorite fish, although it's precisely the sort of no-frills cooking that means Bellamy's has a clientele of regulars who eat here at least once a week. Instead, I ordered steak, a cross-hatched entrecote with crunchy frites to dunk into a béarnaise as thick as custard, though the star side dish was a beautifully crisp salad of perfectly dressed lettuce hearts. Elsewhere there is avocado vinaigrette, brill with red wine butter, rhubarb, crumble with crème anglaise and a chocolate cake made by Rankin's gin-going 86-year-old mother Marina. This approachable exclusivity is one reason Rankin calls his restaurant a club without a sub, and having worked as managing director of Mark Burley's clubs, including Harry's Bar and Annabelle's, before opening Bellamy's 15 years ago, he knows what makes Mayfair locals feel at home. The atmosphere is another. If it's looking like a quiet week for bookings, Rankin will replace a table with a baby grand piano and host cabaret nights. But Parisian brasseries are just as much of an inspiration as London members' clubs. Rankin and his designer Tim Flynn went on a pilgrimage to France to bring home the essence of the perfect brasserie, installing vintage posters and ink-colored banquets, flattering table lamps and kindly angled mirrors. Bellamy's name is a homage to the Gentleman's Club in Evelyn Waugh's Sword of Honor trilogy, but also a pun on Bellamy, French for handsome friend. Just like the Queen, sometimes you need a friend in Mayfair to show you the pleasure to be had in dining out.